go to the next topic. Nathan Winograd, no-kill advocate, has been part of what we've been chatting about, is trying to streamline things in our shelters. Hi, Nathan. Nathan is joining us via Skype from California.
I am. Thank you so much for having me, Christy.
Hey, thanks for chatting with us. I know that you are going to be having a little speech, so to speak, here in the next few weeks. Talk to our viewers, because we've been chatting about, you know, the reality of our animal shelters here. We had a huge fiasco go on in Niagara County SPCA where animals were basically slaughtered. No-kill advocacy, can it happen, and will it work?
Well, the good news is it has happened all over the country. In fact, it happened not too far from you when I was the director of the shelter in Tompkins County, New York. That was the first no-kill community in the United States. And since that time, about 90 communities representing some 300 cities and towns across America have ended the killing, and they're saving upwards of 99% of all the animals at their open admission animal control shelters. And the good news, Christy, is that these communities share nothing in common demographically. You know, some of them are urban, some of them are rural, some of them are northern, some of them are southern, some of them are in historically impoverished areas, some of them are in affluent areas, which tells me that despite all those things that separate us as Americans, people of all walks of life want to build a better world for animals, and that can happen if the shelter takes the lead on the no-kill initiative rather than hiding behind the excuse that there's simply too many animals and not enough homes and using that as an excuse to kill them.
Do you believe that if the elected officials also, or that's where the buck stops, because they are the people that are, in essence, running the machine, whether it's a county shelter or things of that nature, how do you then connect to the elected officials?
Well, the good news is, you know, when somebody puts on their, you know, I'm a city councilman or a commissioner or a state representative, they may be a dog or cat lover, but they have other interests that they must concentrate on. And the good news is, if you look around the country and if you look at how no-kill is implemented, it is much more cost-effective than what we have been doing in Buffalo and across the country, and that is taking the animals in, holding them for a period of time, and then putting them to death. That costs money, and it's wasteful. Adoptions, by contrast, bring in revenue. Partnering with rescue groups transfers the cost of care from taxpayer to private official, so you have a win-win. And when you approach legislators, telling them that not only does the no-kill model save lives, but it is a more cost-effective use of taxpayer dollars. It is consistent with public health and safety. There's simply no reason not to implement no-kill solutions. In fact, doing so costs money. Every animal that's adopted from the from a shelter into a community, that new pet owner is going to spend on average about $1,000 a year on their care. And guess where they're spending it? They're spending it in local veterinarians, at local pet stores, at local pet-related businesses. So not only does it increase revenue to the shelter to save lives, but it also is good for the local economy.
Can you talk a bit about your upcoming speaking engagement here? Because we'll have you on before that, but give our viewers a little heads up.
Well, we're going to bring the good news to Buffalo, New York, about this revolution that's taking place all across the country and must, in fact, take place in Buffalo as well. It's on Sunday, February 17th. It's at the University of Buffalo Center for the Performing Arts, and the good news is it's free. So we'll feed you, we'll expose you to the good news of what the no-kill philosophy represents, how it could be implemented in Buffalo and surrounding communities, and how you can be a part of it. So I'll tell people, come for the food and stay for the presentation, and you'll save lives in the process.
Nathan, I do have your website up, so our viewers can click on the two sides. We wanted just to give them a little tease, a little sneak peek about Nathan Winograd, and we will have you on next week to talk more. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much for having me. It was my pleasure.
Our pleasure as well. Doing good things. I mean, again, you think animals, how do they fit into the political world? It's a multi-billion dollar industry.
Oh, absolutely.
And obviously, all these pieces of the puzzle fit together. We're going to take